Shortly after the collapse of Lehman Brothers in 2008, the Economic Development Corporation was asked by Mayor Bloomberg to think about ways for the city to recover from the downturn. One of the exercises that we launched was an initiative that we called our Game Changers Initiative. If you look at the great centers of innovation in the 21st century around the world, what they all have in common is, at their core, a critical mass of applied sciences, research and development, and talent creation.
The new wealth of countries is knowledge. And I think it was Mayor Bloomberg. He said, knowledge is the new currency.
And it was something that Mayor Bloomberg really believed in. He wants to create another Silicon Valley in New York.
It's Mike Bloomberg's vision. He says it's got to be better. We've got to be better. We've got to transform the city into this amazing tech place. We've got to be a competitor to Silicon Valley.
We would like to invite a top caliber academic institution to build an applied science and engineering school here in New York City.
The success of that competition was driven by the leader at least as much as by everybody else who was involved.
In order to pull something like this together, you need somebody who look far into the future. Nothing could happen without a visionary leader. This is what Michael Bloomberg did.
We are very excited to announce a winner. It is a dynamic joint submission from two world-class institutions, Cornell University and the Technion Israel Institute of Technology. It is thanks to an incredibly generous gift. It comes from Irwin Jacobs and his wife Joan. We are grateful to Irwin and Joan for making this investment in the future of New York City.
What makes the Technion particularly special is not just its academics, the fact that it partners those academics with an ability to create a broader innovation economy around it.
Having close relationship between academia and industry has a huge potential.
People call it a miracle because of the fast transition. If you look back several decades, Israel was based on agriculture, and the Technion managed to drive the transformation of the country into a leading high-tech country, which is ranked now the third in the world in the high-tech industry.
Having foreign students on campus in Israel opened the Technion to influence of other cultures. Our branch in New York brings us closer to the United States. Our branch in China brings us closer to China. We are an Israeli university, but we have global influence.
This uniqueness succeeded to develop generation after generation of young engineers that came out with a culture of impossible is possible.
Air pollution is one of the biggest challenges the world is facing. Every year, more than 3.5 million people die because of air pollution. Our mission is to help to improve the health and quality of life of billions of people worldwide. We gather data from hundreds of thousands of sources and analyze them, and then create a map that shows the air quality in real time at a street level.
We help people with low vision perform daily activities more efficiently, more comfortably, and with more confidence. We designed a system where a low vision person can use a head-mounted display that can identify a particular product, and then it will actually locate the product in an image or in a video.
InsightTech was born to address a vision of a completely non-invasive surgery. Surgery, but without collateral damage, next day back to your life, no blood loss, no infections, no morbidity. This is the operating room of the future.
There's no question in my mind that the arrival of the Technion is not only something that people who care about science and technology should be excited about, but that people who care about the future of New York City should be excited about.
It's Mike Bloomberg's vision and the capability of the Technion that are going to transform New York.
It really is a game changer. It will generate more than $23 billion in economic activity over the next three decades. In a word, this project is going to be transformative.
I think that without being presumptuous, Jacobs Technion, Cornell Institute, and Cornell Tech will play a major role worldwide for innovative spirit, for new ideas. The impact won't be only on New York. It will be on countries around the world.
By supporting the Technion, you support the next entrepreneurs, the next innovators.
This is a very big deal for New York's economy if we're going to stay competitive in a global world as things change very rapidly. Very few things you can do for your children as valuable as trying to leave them a better world.